Hey everyone, it's Andrew Cartwright. I hope you're having a fabulous Saturday. Here's your unemployment update for Saturday, November 28, 2020. Got some great news here. A lot of details to help you out and help you understand unemployment. Find out which state residents started receiving fake unemployment claims that have halted payments to the unemployed. Unbelievable story. And the $100 million deal that is critical for Congress to pass this week as they are set to return Monday. They got a limited window of like 9 to 14 days to get something done. And which state could still pay up to 13 to 20 weeks of extended unemployment benefits after December? Yes, 7 extra weeks, especially for people in these states, which is great news for them. And the details for you if you're not in those states after this. For the best news and information to master and dominate your money, crush it, your business, and your life, stay tuned to this channel. We'll resource the articles. And remember, when you subscribe, like, and comment, you're entered to win $1,200. We had 120,000 subscribers. We're so close. Thank you guys so much for supporting the community. If you're already a subscriber, make sure you put a comment because you don't want to miss out at your chance to win $1,200. Also, go down below. Webull has a special promotion that's pretty crazy. You get 2 stocks for free. And if you open an account, you get another 2 stocks for free. I was looking at it, it's like 4 stocks for free. They change their promotions around, and it's pretty crazy that you can get 4 free stocks. Also, check out our Patreon, where we send out articles every day to help you with your personal finance, make money, and just make better money decisions. But first, residents across Louisiana have received letters tied to fake unemployment claims, approvals for benefits, and even received debit cards loaded with cash benefits for people they don't know who used their address. Yes, you get a card in the mail, you're like, huh, then this has money, but this is not my name, and I don't know why I'm getting this. Louisiana Workforce Commission said earlier this week that they've already stopped 160,000 bogus claims since the virus pandemic started. That means people are just putting in addresses, probably hoping to get to your mailbox before you do. They stated, quote, since the virus breakout, they're looking into unexpected spikes over the past 2 weeks that have tripled the number of application unemployment insurance benefits that the agent had been receiving. So all of a sudden, they get a spike out of the blue, record numbers, and they're like, okay, this doesn't make sense. This is weird. It's gotten to the point where they've decided to halt new payments for first-time claimants made November 5th to put in new security measures. This is terrible. So if you are in Louisiana and you're putting your claim November 5th, well, this new fraud has stopped you from getting your payment. So if you're not getting anything, this is why. This fraud is getting out of hand. And as many people began to go back on unemployment, it needs to be resolved soon. You know, people that are back in those measures where states are shutting down again, people are going back to unemployment that were able to work for a little while, kind of a, you know, yo-yo effect, right? And now we've got this fraud there too, which is popping up around the country. We've reported on California being one of the biggest problems. Meanwhile, Governor Gretchen Whitmer is calling for $100 million state-level economic stimulus to provide direct financial support. Finally, one governor is getting it. A lot of governors are starting to understand they need to spend this money. Congress adjourns on Monday, and Whitmer proposed the legislation passed a pandemic economic aid package during the 3-week lame duck session scheduled to begin Tuesday in Michigan. Whitmer wrote in a letter to legislation top Republican and Democratic leaders stating, quote, it is critical for us to come together now to pass a targeted state-based economic stimulus plan for up to $100 million. Now, obviously, Pelosi was looking at a much, much bigger number to help out the states. This next week is critical for Congress to get the $100 million deal done to help out not only for the state of Michigan, but for all the American states and our territories. They're all just having a hard time. They don't have the revenues to be able to support. I mean, no money coming in. You know, if there's no people aren't selling things and collecting sales tax, states are missing out on money, right? And finally, the pandemic, emergency unemployment compensation offered up to 13 weeks of extra benefits. That was on top of the 26 weeks of unemployment insurance states generally pay through some pay much less. Although we talked about this before, some states, there's a couple of states that pay 27 weeks, one extra week, but majority of them had a baseline of 26 weeks. That was the what everybody pretty much was following, was that standard, that statewide you were okay for 26 weeks and then you would come off of unemployment. Well, when they passed the Federal CARES Act, they gave you a 13 extra weeks, which was fabulous, right? Because that gave us 39 total weeks. And as the economic crisis persists and workers are unemployed for longer periods, the ranks of this program has grown. We had FEMA that covered 5 weeks, which was great, right? Because we ended August, July 31st, and then we had August that was covered and 1 week of September, and then we were out again. Many people who have exhausted their state unemployment insurance would be eligible to continue getting benefits till the end of the year via the state extended benefit program. This gives people 7 more weeks. These benefits become available in states with high levels of unemployment, typically paying out up to 13 weeks to 20 weeks. So this is really good news. Workers can complete their benefits after exhausting the 13 week of the PUC, that's the baseline of that extended. That's not the FPUC that paid the $600 or the FEMA that paid $300. This is separate. This is the base, your base, like 45% of your wages. The state who still are paying out these 13 weeks of extended benefits are Arizona, Colorado, Hawaii, Georgia, Iowa, Kansas, Kentucky, Louisiana, Maryland, Massachusetts, Minnesota, Mississippi, New Hampshire, New Mexico, North Carolina, Oklahoma, Pennsylvania, South Carolina, Texas, Vermont, Virginia, and West Virginia. Now, the states paying out the 20 weeks, the winners of this race, the extended benefits are Alaska, California, Connecticut, Delaware, the District of Columbia, where DC is, Illinois, Michigan, Nevada, New Jersey, New York, Ohio, Oregon, Rhode Island, and Washington. So the 20 weeks, those states, fabulous news for them. The rest of you guys, you got 13 weeks. If you still have not applied for these unemployment assistance, make sure that you get this weekend, get it handled today, Saturday, fill out your application. Could take 15 to 20 minutes. Check out your PUA or your UI. Remember, they're two different sites, and upload your employment history, those documents. Make sure that you give them adequate identification so that you don't get caught up in the bureaucracy. And remind, again, tell them the truth about your work. Don't mess up on those dates, because if it doesn't jive with what they, if it doesn't, isn't the same as what's in their system, if you're saying you worked when you didn't, then there's going to be a problem. So answer truthfully as possible. You could get a backdated check to $10,000 to $15,000. If you did not pay into the system, do not worry. The CARES Act covers you. To all the gig workers and self-employed independent contractors, 1099 workers, even side hustle volunteers or freelancers, you can claim unemployment benefits through the PUA. It is not anything to worry about. You are covered. They made this program especially for you, but there's not much time to waste, because these incredible unemployment benefits that the government extended unprecedentedly ever before. These benefits end December 31st. They're over for some people. It's over December 26th, 27th, day after Christmas. I guess that's your day after Christmas present, right? So keep sharing your experience with the PUA. We love hearing about your all the stuff, unemployment here on these comments, because your state, other people in your state, because we have people that watch all over the United States. We have tons of people, even Puerto Rico and Samoa, the island of Samoa, which is awesome. Thank you so much for watching, all of you, and for supporting us in the community. We appreciate it so much. And if you haven't subscribed, please do it. It'd be great to have you as a subscriber, part of our community. Love to hear what you'd like to see and cover here. We also have free programs with real estate that you can look at, the free real estate stuff. There's no hook or catch there. It's just to help you. I've started 32 companies in 17 industries, and I hope to help you as much as possible reach your dreams and the goals that you have for your life. I love you. Take care.